show you how I rig up. This is technique number one. Technique number two is going to be with the minnow, but I don't have minnows yet, right? And I haven't set up my tent. I haven't done anything yet like that because I want to get my line in the water. I'm hoping I'm going to catch something for dinner tonight. So I've got just a bare hook. It's a number four. I always use those number four hooks. And then on the hook, I'm just going to gob up a worm. Just a full worm. Now, if you like worms, or you're squeamish, and you think it's cruel to a worm, then this technique's not for you. Is a syringe. Carefully, so you don't get yourself. It's a little bit easier to do it on the ground. Inject the worm. Once at the front, if you do it properly. Once at the back, I put too much air in, so that popped out. I'll do a third time. Now, that worm will float. So what I'll do is I'll take the line, I'll run out maybe 10 feet of line, and then I'll put my split shot at the end. So if you can picture that, the worm floating up and the sinker floating down. So that's going to be, the worm's going to be up here. So any fish that's cruising down on the bottom is going to see that and come up and grab it. And it also means I don't have to do anything. I don't have to worry about snags. Okay, sorry, the battery died there, but what I'll do is I'll take the line and I'll paddle out as far as I can, and I'll drop it down. So like I'll use the entire spool of line practically because I want to get out as far away from the shore as possible. This water is really clear and the fish are really spooky because it's clear. They can see everything. So this is a way to get the line out really far and just leave it. So you don't have to paddle, you don't have to troll, you're not spooking any fish, you're just leaving it. And then a fish is going to come lazily up and see it and grab it. So this is the way. You don't have to troll, you don't have to paddle, you don't have to do anything. Just go out, set your line, leave it, come back to shore, sit. So I'll do that now. I'll paddle out and drop it back, and then I'm going to set up the tent. Okay, so the line's all set now. I actually figured out a cool thing. I can stick it in the canoe. The top, that's for a light, but that works great. So you can see most of my spool is out, it's practically empty there. And then I've got a bell at the end, and I'll have to rewrap that, but I don't know if this is gonna work here because it's a little bit on the shallow side. We always used to fish over there. Well, but the only time I came, if we fished over there. So I might go over there after if this doesn't work. But if it works, hey, I'll just fish right here. It'll be perfect. So anyway, I'll let the worm do the work for me. I got the bell on there. And now I can go set up my tent. And I've got a shot at catching fish and eating fish. I always tell my son, if you don't have your line in the water, you can't catch fish. So I'm following my own advice. And I can use the time while I sit and wait for a bite to do the rest of the stuff that needs to get done.